alcohol. So it is considered as action with the silver hydroxide. Silver oxide reacts with the water in forms silver oxide. So X selected is X, it is Y. So X and Y are same compounds. X is ethyl alcohol, Y is also ethyl alcohol. So it is the first method from alkali halides. So alkali halides printed with aqueous KOH or moist silver oxide is ethyl alcohol. Next, the second one. Second, from esters. From esters. Ester means R, COOR, R dash. R dash means R and R are different. It is methyl, it is ethyl. Okay? So, take ethyl acetate, CH3, COO, C2H5. Ethyl acetate is commonly ester, so ethyl acetate. This ethyl acetate on hydrolysis in alkaline medium, either KOH or NaOH, aqueous KOH or aqueous NaOH. So hydrolysis on aqueous medium. So esters on hydrolysis. So it gives, so bond is broken here. So it gives ethyl alcohol, C2H5OH and CH3COOKe is the byproduct. Potassium acetate. If you take aqueous sodium hydroxide, sodium acetate is the byproduct. So esters on hydrolysis in alkaline medium. In alkaline means basic medium. So it gives alcohol. Next. So these esters also, from esters, esters are reduction. Reduction. So reduction means addition of hydrogen by using lithium aluminium hydride LiAlH4 or hydrogenation, catalytic hydrogenation or hydrogenation in the presence of acids. Okay, so it is considered as hydrogenation or lithium aluminium hydride, sodium borohydride, these are all the reducing agents. Esters on hydrolysis in alkaline medium gives ethyl alcohol. Ethyl means gives alcohol. So ethyl acetate gives ethyl alcohol, one mole of potassium acetate. Whereas on the reduction, this ethyl acetate gives 2 moles of ethyl alcohol, C2H5. So alkyl halides treated with aqueous KOH or moist silver oxide gives ethyl alcohol. Ethyl acetate on hydrolysis in alkaline medium, it gives 1 mole of ethyl alcohol and 1 mole of sodium or potassium acetate. Next one, on the reduction by using lithium aluminium hydride or catalytic hydrogenation or hydrogenation in acidic medium, so it gives ethyl alcohol. So here only 1 mole of ethyl alcohol is formed, here it gives 2 moles of ethyl alcohol. So it is the second method. From alkyl halides is the first method. Next, the second one from esters is the second. Next, the third one. From carbonyl compounds. From carbonyl compounds. Either carboxylic acids. Carboxylic acids. Carboxylic acids. So from carbonyl compounds and carboxylic acids. Example, take acetaldehyde, CH3, CHO, it is acetaldehyde. Acetaldehyde on the reduction in the presence of lithium aluminium hydride. So acetaldehyde contains two carbons. Okay? So here, CH2OH. Acetaldehyde is reduced to ethyl alcohol. Means aldehydes on the reduction. Aldehydes. It is acetaldehyde. So aldehydes on the reduction gives primary alcohol. So aldehydes on reduction gives primary alcohol. Okay? Next one. Ketones on the reduction. Example, acetone, CH3. How many alias acetone? Okay. So it is the ketone. It is the simplest ketone. So generally ketones are also reduced in presence of magnesium, right? Sodium borohydride NaBH4. LiLH4 is also used. As compared to lithium aluminum hydride, we have used sodium borohydride. It is a mild reducing agent. Mild reducing agent is also enough. Okay? So it is ketone. So ketones are reduces to secondary alcohol. It is isopropyl alcohol. So it is the secondary alcohol. So aldehydes are reduction. So aldehydes are reduces to primary alcohol. Ketones are reduces to secondary alcohol. Next, carboxylic acids. Example, you take acetic acid. CH3COOH acetic acid. Okay. So all reduction in the presence of lithium aluminium hydride. Lithium aluminium hydride. So carboxylic acids also gives primary alcohol. Example, acetic acid is reduces to ethyl alcohol. Acetic acid contains two carbons. Ethyl alcohol. So it gives alcohol with two carbons. So it is also primary alcohol. So in the last class, these three methods completed. From alkyl halides, from carbonyl compounds, from esters, next to carboxylic acids. Okay? So carbonyl compounds and carboxylic acids. So carbonyl compounds are reduction due to primary alcohols. Ketones are reduction gives secondary alcohols. Carboxylic acids are reduction gives primary alcohols. Okay? So in the last class, these three methods completed. The next two, fourth method. Fourth method from Grignard series. Fourth one from Grignard series. For fourth one from Grignard series. Grignard's reagent is RGS from Grignard's reagent. Okay, so from Grignard's reagent. So fourth one from Grignard's reagent. From Grignard's reagent. All MGX, it is a Grignard's reagent. It is also very important reaction. It will be repeated in the next chapter, that is carbonyl compounds. So Grignard's reagent means all MGX. All MGX. Okay? So Grignard's reagent reacts with the formaldehyde followed by hydrolysis. Formaldehyde is the HCHO. So treated with the formaldehyde followed by hydrolysis, it gives primary alcohol. Okay? So Grignard's reagent reacts with formaldehyde followed by hydrolysis, gives primary alcohol. Next, Grignard's reagent reacts with aldehydes other than formaldehyde. So reacts with any aldehyde means other than formaldehyde gives primary alcohol. So other than formaldehyde, if you take any aldehyde followed by hydrolysis, it gives a secondary alcohol. Next, any ketone, any ketone gives followed by hydrolysis. Treated with Grignard's reagent followed by hydrolysis, it gives tertiary alcohol. Okay, so this reaction is very important. So in aldehydes, simplest aldehyde, that is a formaldehyde. Okay, so any glycerol reaction treated with the formaldehyde followed up by alkalosis, it gives a primary alcohol. Other than the formaldehyde, remaining all aldehydes reacts with the glycerol reaction followed up by alkalosis, gives a secondary alcohol. Next, any keto reacts with the glycerol reaction followed by alkalosis gives tertiary alcohol. Okay, so formaldehyde gives primary alcohol. Next, other than formaldehyde, remaining all aldehyde gives secondary alcohol. Next, third one, any keto reacts with the Grignard's reaction followed by hydrolysis, it gives tertiary alcohol. Okay, so formaldehyde gives primary alcohol, followed by hydrolysis, two step reaction. Here, intermediate compound is also formed. Other than formaldehyde, remaining all followed by hydrolysis gives secondary alcohol. Next, any keto reacts with the Grignard's reaction followed by hydrolysis gives tertiary alcohol. So primary, secondary, tertiary alcohols are prepared from Grignard's reaction. So to prepare primary alcohol, we use formaldehyde. To prepare secondary alcohol, we take any aldehyde other than formaldehyde, esteraldehyde, propylaldehyde, butylaldehyde, etc. To prepare tertiary alcohol, we use any ketone. So any ketone, first ketone or simplest ketone is acetone. So acetone reacts with the Grignard's reaction followed by hydrolysis, it gives so tertiary. Okay, so take a particular example, Grignard's reaction. Here we use methyl magnesium iodide, CH3, MgI, it is a methyl magnesium iodide, okay? So reacts with the formaldehyde, HCWO2OH, it is a formaldehyde. It is a formaldehyde. CH3MgI is a methyl magnesium iodide. Methyl magnesium iodide. So, in the first step, it forms intermediate compound. Carbon is more electronegative than carbon. So, this oxygen gets a partial negative charge. Next one, carbon gets a partial positive charge. So it is ionized to magnesium is a metal. So it is ionized to MgI plus and CH3 minus. Okay, magnesium is a metal. It combines with the fluorine carbonate, I minus. Magnesium is a divalent. Magnesium is a divalent. It combines with only one iodide. So MgI plus, it carries one unit positive charge. So Grignard's reaction is ionized to R minus and MgI plus. Okay, so this MgI plus is added to negatively charged oxygen. Next, to CH3 minus methyl carbon ion is added to. So here, so negatively charged carbon is added to positively charged carbon. Here, intermediate compound is formed. So what is the intermediate compound? This is CH3 is added to carbon. So it is a hedge. It is a hedge. So CH3 is added to this carbon. Next, it is a O. MgI is added to this carbon. It is the intermediate compound. Followed by hydrolysis. Second step. Followed by hydrolysis means treated with water. Treated with water. So bond is broken here. So bond is broken here. H is added to oxygen, what is it? Is to H plus OH minus. H is added to oxygen, OH is added to MgI. So here the product formed is, it is CH3. So this carbon is attached with the two hydrogens and one methyl group. This OH is converted to OH. I know MgOHI is the byproduct. from G, OH alkali is the byproduct. So it is considered as, so starts from CH3, it is a CH3. This CH3 is attached with the CH2. This CH2 is attached with the OH. CH3, CH2, OH means ethyl alcohol is obtained. So ethyl alcohol is, it is the primary alcohol because of OH is attached with the primary carbon. So it is, it gives primary alcohol. So it is the intermediate compound. So Grignard series it reacts with formaldehyde. It forms an intermediate compound followed by hydrolysis. It gives ethyl alcohol. So methyl magnesium iodide reacts with formaldehyde followed by hydrolysis. It gives ethyl alcohol. So ethyl alcohol is the primary alcohol. Okay. So formaldehyde reacts with the Grignard series and followed by hydrolysis. It gives primary alcohol. Suppose here we did C2H5MgI, ethyl magnesium iodide. Ethyl magnesium iodide. So ethyl group has two carbons. Formaldehyde contains one carbon, 2+1, 3 carbons means propyl alcohol, n-propyl alcohol is okay. So here ethyl magnesium iodide reacts with formaldehyde. It forms an intermediate compound. It undergoes hydrolysis. So bond is broken here. So CH3, CH2, OH means ethyl alcohol is formed. And what is the byproduct? So byproduct, it has less importance. It has less importance. Mg, OHI, magnesium hydroxy iodide is the byproduct. It is the first one. Next, the second one. Other than formaldehyde. If you use any aldehyde other than formaldehyde. Suppose we take acetaldehyde. Okay. So what is the formula of acetaldehyde? CH3CHO CWO OH. It is acetaldehyde. It is called acetaldehyde. So Grignard's reagent methyl magnesium iodide reacts with the Grignard's reagent. So this oxygen gets a partial negative charge. This carbon gets a partial positive charge. So negative charge to CH3 minus is at to carbonyl carbon. Next one. So here intermediate compound is formed. So it is CH3. Next it is CH. Here CH3 minus is added to this carbon. Pi bond is broken. MgI is added to carbonyl oxygen. So it is the intermediate compound. So this intermediate compound on hydrolysis. This intermediate compound on hydrolysis. So bond is broken here. Okay. So OH is added to OH minus is added to MgI. H plus is at what is minus H plus and OH minus. H plus is at to carbonyl oxygen. So here the product formed is CH3. It is a C. It is attached with the H. It is a CH3. This C is attached with OH. So OH is added to this carbon. This carbon is attached with another two carbon atoms. So it is the secondary alcohol. So other than formaldehyde. So any other aldehyde except or other than formaldehyde is a secondary alcohol. Total number of carbons 1, 2, 3 carbon. So it is called, common name is isopropyl alcohol. Isocarbon. Any keto reacts with or Grignard's reagent followed by hydrolysis. So it is acetone. It is the simplest keto. Simplest keto means the first keto. CH3, CBO, CH3. So it is called acetone. So here it forms an intermediate compound. So followed by hydrolysis, any ketone gives tertiary alcohol. So carbon oxygen gets partially into the is carbonyl carbon gets a partial positive charge. So renoxyacin CH3 has a negative charge, MgI has a positive charge. So CH3 minus is added to positively charged carbon. MgI plus is added to negatively charged oxygen. Here pi bond is broken. So here the intermediate component formed is CH3. This is C. Here CH3 minus is added. So already it has a CH3 in this position. Next it is O. MgI is added to carbonyl oxygen. So it is the intermediate component. Okay. Next, all hydrolysis. Second step, all hydrolysis. Here bond is broken. Okay. OH is added to O2 minus is added to MgI. H plus is added to oxygen. So here the product formed is CH3. It is the middle carbon. It is attached with another two methyl groups. It is CH3. It is CH3. Here O is attached with that. Okay. So OH is attached with this middle carbon. This middle carbon is attached with how many other carbons? 1, 2, 3 carbons. So it is secondary carbon or tertiary carbon? It is the tertiary carbon atom. So it is called a tertiary alcohol. So common name is, common name, total number of carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons. So common name, tertiary, total number of carbons, 4. So tertiary butyl alcohol. Tertiary butyl alcohol. What is the IUPAC name? What is the IUPAC name? It is the common name. Common name is tertiary butyl alcohol. What is the IUPAC name? First, select the longest chain. So it is considered as the longest chain. OH group is attached with the second carbon. Same second carbon is also attached with the methyl group. So first, mention the substituent. So that is methyl group. This methyl group is attached with the second carbon. So 2-methyl root wall contains 3 carbons of rock. Carbon-carbon containing a single bond, so propane is easily replaced by OH group. Mention the position of OH group. This OH group is also attached with the second carbon. So 2-methyl propane to bond, common name is tertiary butyl alcohol. Tertiary butyl alcohol. Okay, so it is the from Grignard's reagent. So from Grignard's reagent we can prepare primary alcohol, secondary alcohol, and tertiary alcohol. So formaldehyde gives primary alcohol. Next to other than formaldehyde, remaining all aldehydes gives. So remaining all aldehydes give secondary alcohol. Any ketone reacts with Grignard's reagent followed by hydrolysis, it gives tertiary alcohol. Okay, no? So it is a very important reaction. It will also repeat in next chapter, that is carbonyl compound. So carbonyl compound. So it is the property of carbonyl compounds, aldehydes and the ketones. Okay? Right. So consolidate all the three reactions. So methyl magnesium iodide, CH3, MgI, methyl magnesium iodide reacts with formaldehyde HCHO followed by hydrolysis. Followed by hydrolysis gives G. Next one. Treated with acetaldehyde CH3CHO. Followed by hydrolysis. It gives B. Next one. So it reacts with the first step. Reacts with acetyl-CH3-CO-CH3. Second step followed by hydrolysis. It gives C. So what are A, B, and C? Are the correct statements about A, B, C? Are the wrong statements about A, B, C? So first, what are A, B, C? So A is primary alcohol, B is secondary alcohol, C is tertiary alcohol. Okay? So with the formula, A is primary alcohol, it is correct. B is secondary alcohol, correct. So any other aldehyde gives secondary alcohol, it is ketone. Any ketone gives tertiary alcohol. So A is primary alcohol, B is secondary alcohol, C is tertiary alcohol. What is A? So formaldehyde has only one carbon. Another carbon is coming from C3H6. So A is CH3CH2OH. Ethyl alcohol. It is a primary alcohol. What is B? Acetaldehyde has two carbons. One carbon is coming from C3H6. So any other aldehyde other than formaldehyde, it gives a secondary alcohol. So it is a CH3. Next, it is a CH. This CH3 is coming from C3H6. Next, it is OH. OH group is attached with the secondary carbon. It is the secondary carbon. So it is called a secondary alcohol. Isopropyl alcohol or propyl OH. What is a C? C is a tertiary alcohol. Here C is a tertiary alcohol. So acetone has already three carbons. CH3 three carbons. One carbon is coming from C3H6. It is OH. So common name is tertiary butyl alcohol. It is a tertiary alcohol. So this method is very important. So C3H6 reacts with the formaldehyde followed by dialysis. Use primary alcohol. Next, other than formaldehyde, remaining all aldehydes reacts with the C3H6 followed by hydrolysis. The secondary alcohol. Next, any ketone reacts with the C3H6 followed by hydrolysis. It gives tertiary alcohol. So it is a transformation. The next, remaining two reactions from alkenes. That is the fifth method from alkenes. From alkenes. So it is very important method both objective and PU exam. So mechanism also behavior here, hydration. So mechanism is also important. Next to, so first one, primary alcohols, alkyl halides, second one from esters, third one from carbonyl compound, fourth one from C3H6. Next to fifth method from alkenes. Fifth and sixth methods are very important for alkenes. Okay? So alkenes means here we take specific example. Ethylene, CH2 double bond CH2. Ethylene. Okay? So this ethylene gas is obtained in the pyrolysis. Pyrolysis means cracking of petroleum. So this ethylene gas is passed through concentrated sulfuric acid followed by hydrolysis, it gives ethyl alcohol. So here the product formed is nearly 75 to 80 degrees centigrade temperature. So nearly about 75 to 80 degrees centigrade temperature. So here it forms an intermediate compound. So what is the temperature? Nearly 80 degrees centigrade. 75 to 80 degrees centigrade. So sulfuric acid is NH2 H plus and O HSO4 minus. It is the initial reaction. So it is the electrophilic addition. First one, CH2 HSO4 undergoes hydrolysis followed by hydrolysis means on heating of water. So bond is broken here. So H is added to bisulfite ion, OH minus is added to C2H5. So H plus is added to HSO4. So here CH3, CH2, OH ethyl alcohol and sulfuric acid H plus 4. So in this reaction, so this ethyl hydrogen sulfate on heating with water means it undergoes hydrolysis. Alcohol. Formaldehyde react with 90% of ethyl alcohol is prepared from ethylene. Okay. So this gaseous state, ethylene is passed into concentrated sulfuric acid. Ethyl hydrogen sulfate is formed. So followed by hydrolysis, it gives ethyl alcohol. Means ethylene reacts with water. So what is the complete reaction? Ethylene reacts with water in presence of sulfuric acid is also considered. Ethylene reacts with water in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, it acts as a catalyst. Okay, so about 72, 75 to 80 degrees centigrade. Water is ionized to H plus and OH minus. H plus is at one carbon, OH minus is at another carbon. Here pi bond is broken. So CH3, CH2, OH. Okay, so it is a method of preparation of ethyl alcohol from keys. Next, suppose we take unsymmetric alkene CH3, CH double bond CH2, propene. It is considered as unsymmetric alkene means. So these two double bonded carbons, this carbon is attached with two hydrogens, this carbon is attached with CH3 and one hydrogen. Here double bonded carbons attached with two hydrogens and two hydrogens. Okay, so ethylene is a symmetric alkene, propane is an unsymmetric alkene, butane is unsymmetric alkene, whereas 2-butane is a symmetric alkene. CH3, CH2, CH double bond CH2. It is 1-butane. It is unsymmetric alkene. Whereas 2-butane is symmetric alkene. CH3, CH double bond CH3. 2-butane. It is a symmetric alkene because of it is attached with the CH3. It is also attached with. Okay. So 1-butane is unsymmetric alkene. Whereas 2-butane is a symmetric alkene. Here propane is either symmetric alkene or unsymmetric alkene. Unsymmetric alkene. So unsymmetric alkene reacts with water in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid at about 80 degrees centigrade. So here two compounds are possible. What are the possible compounds? Here how many compounds are possible? Two compounds are possible. So what are the possible compounds? If H is added to this carbon, first possibility. So first possibility, if H is added, H plus is added to this carbon, then OH minus is added to this carbon. It is the first possibility. Then here the compound formed is CH3. CH2, pi bond is broken, CH2OH. Okay, it is the primary alcohol, N-propyl alcohol. What is the second possibility? Second possibility, H plus is added to this carbon, OH minus is added to this carbon, it is the second possibility. So, what is the second compound possible? Possible second compound is CH3, CH2OH. It is the secondary alcohol. It is called isopropyl alcohol. Okay? When unsymmetric alkenes reacts with water in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acids, how many compounds are possible? Two compounds are possible. First one is N-propyl alcohol, second one is isopropyl alcohol. So what is the major product? Isopropyl alcohol is the major product. More than 95%, almost 97% of isopropyl alcohol is obtained. Just 3%, less than 5% of n-propyl alcohol is obtained. So how to identify the major product means? Here we should follow the Markovnikov rule. So major product formed according to Markovnikov rule. We know anti-Markovnikov rule. What is Markovnikov rule and what is anti-Markovnikov rule? So Markovnikov rule and anti-Markovnikov rule already used in alkyl amines. Here negative part, OH minus is the negative part. So according to Markovnikov rule, negative part is added to double bonded carbon with less number of hydrogens. Means OH minus is added to middle carbon, it is the Markovnikov rule. So according to Markovnikov rule, major product is isopropyl alcohol. So here we follow the Markovnikov rule. According to Markovnikov rule, negative part is added to double bonded carbon with less number of hydrogens. So it is double bonded carbon. Negative part is added to double bonded carbon with less number of hydrogens. Okay, so it is the Markovnikov. So what is anti-Markovnikov rule? It is also called Karasch effect. Karasch effect. So it is the Markovnikov rule. What is anti-Markovnikov rule? Anti-Markovnikov rule. It is also called Karasch. So if you use peroxide, so negative part is added to double bonded carbon with more number of hydrogens. It is anti-Markovnikov, means opposite to Markovnikov rule. It is called anti-Markovnikov rule. So in case of unsymmetric alkenes, reacts with water in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, two compounds are possible. So it is the first possibility, it is the second possibility. So here major product is according to Markovnikov rule, isopropyl alcohol is the major product. So here we should follow the Markovnikov rule. Means the negative part is added to double bonded carbon with more number of, less number of hydrogens. It is the Markovnikov rule. Okay, next. Here in PO point of view or in objective point of view, so mechanism is important. So from alkenes, so mechanism is important. So this reaction takes place in three steps. Come, practice the mechanism. It is very important. So first step. Step one. What is the step one? This reaction takes place in the three steps. So in the first step, protonation of alkenes. So protonation of proton is H plus. Electrophilic addition. So protonation. Protonation of alkene. So characteristic properties of alkenes are electrophilic substitution reactions. Proton means H plus. So first step, suppose we take ethylene, CH2 double bond CH2. First step, protonation H plus. Okay, so it is the protonation. H plus is added to, so this is one of the double bonded carbons. Suppose this H plus is added to, this pi electrons are supposed to get to this carbon. This carbon gets a negative charge. This carbon gets a positive charge. So this electrophile is added to negatively charged carbon. So it is a CH3. In case of CH2, it forms a carbocation. It is the primary carbocation. So first step, protonation of alkene. So protonation of alkene to form carbocation by electrophilic attack of protonation of alkene and to form carbocation. Carbocation. To form carbocation.